That was me. It was me. My flamenco friends, welcome to the Temple of Flamenco from El Payo Humberto. Here we are. Again. Well, I said that I was, because a little more closer. Okay. A few months ago, somebody wrote a comment to my YouTube, and the man said in Spanish, Humberto, you're not playing arpeggios. You could hear it, because I was playing tarantas, near Ricardo, arpeggios. He was very smart. But it was the first time that somebody notices I never played arpeggios. And why? Well, I don't have it. I had it. I had a favorite arpeggio, tremolo. Not so good picado, was not my strong point. But will arpeggio, good asapua, thumb. So, well, it started vanishing in 83. This recording is from 82, from my CD. Ecos del pasado, there are echoes. And I had a lot of treatments, physiotherapy, chiropractic, homeopathy, and nothing helps, all those treatments. And a little by little, I started with this finger, I think it's the ring finger, and that finger. This finger still okay, index finger. And the thumb. And the left hand is okay. So I start seeking, because the way of Nirikara has a lot of arpeggios. And then Alvar Nguyen, the great guitarist, Perico El de Lunar, father. He had the same problem. He was playing before with recordings with Chacon, for example. Very nice, arpeggio, tremolo, everything. And he had the same problem. He was playing like this. Little this, left. But he was playing more simple notes, more feeling. Zoals said to Pepe Avicuela, listen to Perico. And Pepe was surprised. Yes, what he can do with two or three notes. Even Sabicas said to me many years ago, the most important, the art, the revelation of art, are two or three notes. And Sabicas had a great technique. So I start studying Perico El de Lunar. And also Nino Perez. Not so good as Perico, but also a very good guitarist. And they played the Zambra. The Zambra, the very famous Tablao van Hunk in Madrid. Opens in 55 en closed in 75. With great singers, Juan Barea, Perico de Cádiz, Rafael Romero. Dancing, Rosa Duran. I have still a record. I bought it for 9 euros, like $9, a few weeks ago. I had it already. But Zambra, this is, I don't know what year, the 60s, early 60s. And Neo Perez is playing then in Kanya with the dance. I don't know if it was Rosa Duran or other dancer. Let it be. With Perico de Cádiz, great singer, or Kanya. Neo Perez was playing very simple, but very strong, you know, like rocks. And big trees, you know, the old style. Yes. So that's what I did. Studying mainly Perico de Luna. And then there was the thumb left. I had Rasgueo. And the left hand, okay. But without two fingers. And I start to play in the old way. The arpeggio, for example, even I think Javier Molina was playing a simple technique, but he was a great guitarist. Great guitarist. Javier Molina. He was the teacher of the master of Perico el de Luna. In these days, I can't play 10 or 12 numbers, but I can play in a concert, little concert, 5 or 6 solos. And with singers, no problem. Because the singer, what he wants, a good accompaniment. Compass first place, giving the tone the right moment. For Satas, he wants to hear flamenco. And the most important thing with a lot of technique or lesser is the expression. It has to be flamenco. No? That is the most important thing. So, what can I say? four numbers. With my technique. Then the fifth also, still. The sixth number was the Solejaris. And then I made an anthology, a bunch of falsettos from Perico de Luna, what he did with singers, accompaniment. I made a solo, a little solo. Let's listen.
This is very different. More simple. That's okay. Number six. Number 5. Het is een Solearis. With Juan Barea. Great singer. Nobody is talking. Juan Barea. He's a great singer. A great man. He was a, what they say in Spanish, un caballero. A great singer. And you can listen the same falsetto. He was in Paris. In, I think, a 50, from the 56 or 59, former century. And Barreiros, and I liked him. I worked with him, with Barreiros Morente, and Perico Lunar Hijo, many years ago, 69, I think, Colegio. Quieto ahí.
Yeah.